Hello people, this is SelfTurks and in this video we'll learn how to do auto completion of Python code in Vim. So I have gone through many tutorials on internet, I have gone through many videos, but I have not found any 100% working solution which gives you code completion of Python in Vim. So I'm guaranteeing you this time that in this video if you follow all my steps, then you'll get 100% code completion in your Vim for Python development. So what we are going to do in this particular tutorial? So in this particular tutorial, we are going to do Python code auto completion in Vim, which means there is a Vim installed on your system. We installed the latest version of Vim, that is Vim 8.1 currently, and then we'll compile that particular Vim with Python 3 support. So this particular Vim will have a Python 3 support, and what we'll do, we'll use uCompleteMe Vim plugin to and we'll inject this particular plugin in Vim so that autocode completion for Python works in our Vim. So this is what we'll get after following this tutorial, that if you see here, if there's schema written here and if you put a dot, then it gives all the methods, all the properties that are present on this particular variable, and you get this type of auto completion in Vim, which is awesome. So let's start it. So what we'll do, we'll install this particular setup on a CentOS system, which is a Linux system. So the CentOS system is already present with me. You can take your own Linux system, or you can take your MacBook, or you can take your Ubuntu system, anything. But the steps will be same. The commands will be different for different Linux distros. So I'm explaining it for CentOS 7, and after some days I'll create for other Linux distros also. So this is my CentOS system, and if I type here Vim command, you can see there's no Vim present. So I'll go to my browser, and what I'll do, I'll try to search for EPL release latest 7. So this is just a Google search, and this will give me a link. So I'll click on this first link. And what I'll do, I'll go to this particular website. So the first step of our Python code completion in Vim says that you need to add EPL7 repo to your CentOS system. So this is a repository which your Linux system CentOS uses to search new software or new releases of software. So if you type the command yum install this git, yum install vim, anything, so it will search this particular repo and it will try to download it from there. So we are on this website, and here you can see this is my EPL release latest 7 RPM. So you can see on the bottom that there will be a link of .rpm. So what I'll do, I'll copy it, the link, and then I'll go to my CentOS system and I'll use the wget command. You can do it anyway. You can download it on your browser and then you can copy it here. So what I'll do, I'll get wget, and this will download the EPL repository for me. Now what I need to do, I need to install it. So I'll do sudo rpm-ivh, which is a command to install any RPM on your CentOS system. So it is sudo rpm-this particular RPM name. So I'll do this, and it has been successfully installed. So once we have successfully added EPL7 repository to our system, the next step in our installation is update your CentOS system. So to update your CentOS system, we'll type the command sudo yum update, and we'll go to this particular terminal and we'll say sudo yum update. So what this will do, this will try to update the current CentOS system with all the latest repos and other things, all the latest software that has been released. So it will ask you for a confirmation. So I'll give yes, and depending on your internet connection, it will take time to update your system. As you can see, yum has been successfully updated. So we'll go to our next step, and the next step says what? We need to install development tools for CentOS. So we need to type this command sudo yum group install development tools, so that when we compile our Vim from its source, or when we configure our Vim from its source, then the necessary development tools are present there. So what we'll do, we'll type command sudo yum, and then we'll say group install what? Development tools. So it will be development tools. So once we are done with it, then all the development tools needed to compile our Vim will be present. So it says that group development, I think there's a spelling mistake, so it will be development tool. So it will try to search our yum repository again, and it will try to install it from there. So you can see here again, we need to download these particular packages. So once it is successfully downloaded, then we'll go to our next step. So the development tools has been successfully installed and we'll go to our next step. So the next step says that we need to install the ncurses development dependencies which is needed for our Vim. So it says here we need to install it, and by using what? Sudo yum install ncurses devel. So we'll again say here, we'll clear the screen and we'll say sudo yum install ncurses and then devel. Okay, so I think the spelling is correct. Ncurses. It is ncurses. Okay, so it will try to install it, and again it will find it in the repository and it will install. So it is a small development dependency, so it will be installed on the fly. Now we have installed ncurses successfully, we'll go to our next step and we'll do what? We need to install Python 3 devel tools. So Python 3 devel tools is necessary because we need to compile our Vim with Python 3 support. So how to install Python 3 devel tool? So I'll clear the screen first, and then what we'll do, we'll search the Python 3 devel in our yum repository. So we'll say what? Yum search and then what? Python. So we'll search for Python, and this will give all the RPMs or all the software which are present on our yum repository related to Python. So it will search the different repositories that are present. So these many Python RPMs are present, but we are interested in what? We are interested in such RPM which is Python 3 devel. So we'll try to filter it out by using grep command of Linux, which is grep and devel. So this will do what? This will again give me a list of so many things. So I'll search for what? Yum search Python 3 and then devel. So you can see here there is Python 3.4 devel.86 libraries and header files needed for Python 3 development. So we need to install this. So we'll copy this one and we'll type the command what? Sudo and then yum install and this particular file name that we have copied. So we'll type it here, and this will try to fetch the data from our yum repositories, and it will download it and then it will install it. So once this gets successfully installed, we'll move to our next step. So the next step will be what? We need to install Python 3.4 with enabled shared flag. So we need to have Python 3.4 on our system, and we will compile it, we'll install with enabled shared flag. So we'll go to our Chrome browser, and here we'll search for what? We'll search for Python 3.4 and then tar download. So we'll say Python 3.4 tar download. Here we'll say get a link of all those index FTP Python 3.4.0. So I'm not saying that this is the particular step to download it. You can download it from anywhere else. So this is just a Google search I'm doing, and I'll download it from here. So here you can see there's Python 3.4.0 tar.gz, and on the below here you can see that the link is also present. So I'll just right click here and I'll do a copy link address. Now I'll go to my terminal, and here you can see it is asking me the last command that we are trying to install. It is asking me yes. So all the Python devel tools will be installed by typing yes here. So it has been successfully installed. Now we want to install Python 3.4. So we'll first download the tar. So we'll go to our cdopt and using sudo command and then wget, we'll copy the link that we have copied from the browser from here, and we'll paste it here. So we'll do wget and it will try to download the tar file of Python 3.4. So after downloading the Python 3.4 tar file, we'll untar it and we'll try to install it. So the tar file has been successfully downloaded. We'll do a ls here, and we can see here this Python 3.4.0 tdz. So now we'll try to untar it by firing the command what? Sudo tar minus xvzf and then the name of the tar file. So it will untar my tar file. I'll do a ls here, and you can see the folder has been created. So I'll go inside this particular folder, and here you can see all these things are present. All these files which are needed to compile my Python 3.4.0 is present here. So we'll go to our next step, and which says that install Python 3.4 with enable shared flag. So how to do that? So we have come inside this particular directory where this Python 3.4.0 is present. So we'll say what? Configure and then enable shared. So we need to pass this flag because it is important. So we'll say configure enable shared, and it will configure our Python installation files so that we can install it. So we have successfully configured our Python, and then what we need to do, we need to make this. So we'll type the command sudo make. These are some default steps that are needed when we install any Linux software using the Linux source code. So if you are installing any software in Linux using the source code of that particular project or that particular software, then these steps are necessary, that is configure step, then make step, and then make install step. So depending on the speed of your CPU, it will take time to make these particular files. So the make process has been successfully executed, and now what we'll do, we'll try to install Python. So we'll type the command sudo make alt install. So alt install is necessary because we are trying to install an alternative Python and we are not trying to override the system Python. So system uses Python 2.7.0, which is necessary, and we are trying to install Python 3 plus, that is Python 3.4. So we'll make a command of alt install, which means alternative install. So we'll type this command and we'll hit enter. So what this will do, this will copy the files to those particular directories where we can where our system will automatically get those files while executing Python 3.4. so we'll see in just a bit that all these files has been installed, and then we can execute the Python 3.4 command. So sudo make alt install has been successfully executed, and now if we go for user bin and then you type Python and then tab, you can see all these things are present here. That is what, these things, Python 3.4, Python 3.4 config. So these Python 3.4 config is present here because of the Python 3 devel tools which we have installed, and this Python 3.4 is present because we have installed Python 3.4. so if I say Python 3.4 minus minus version, so it will give me Python 3.4.8. so we have successfully executed this step of installing Python. So what to do next? So the next is what, install Vim with Python 3 interpreter. So we will download Vim from the source of Vim. The people, those have uploaded it on GitHub. So we'll say GitHub. So we'll type GitHub Vim and it will take us to the repository. So here it is, Vim text editor. We'll click on that, and this is the Vim official repository. So what we'll do, we will clone it. So after cloning it, what we'll get, we'll get the latest version of Vim that is currently being shared by those Vim guys. So we'll come here and we'll ccd dot dot, and here what we'll do, we'll get clone. So either you can clone it or you can download a zip and paste it here, so it is up to you. So it says permission denied, so I'll say sudo because the folder is of root permission. So it doesn't depend on how you do a git clone, you do a wget. It, the main thing is what, you need to put those files here so that we can work on it. So what I have done here, I have used the git clone command because git is present on my system, and that git clone will do what, it will clone all the files from this repo to here. Okay, so Vim has been successfully cloned, and now what we need to do, we need to compile Vim with Python 3. So we'll do a ls here, and you can see here this Vim folder is present. So we'll go inside this Vim, and now we need to compile here. So I have already pasted a code on my gist on the Selfdirt's GitHub account. You can also go there. I'll give the link on in the descriptions below. So you will go to that particular gist and you can take it from there. So this is github.com. So I'm inside my profile, and here I'll search for your gist. I'll give this particular file link, and this is vim8 configure. So vim8 configure command with Python 3 support. So you need to copy this command. I'll explain you this command. So this is what, these are some features that you want to enable in Vim. So here you can see this enable Python 3 interpreter is yes. So this will be configured with Python 3 interpreter. This Vim will be configured with Python 3 interpreter. Now you need to provide the Python 3 config directory, and as you remember, we have installed Python 3 devel tools, and in the Python 3 devel tools, you can see here user bin. I have shown you this previously also, this Python, and if I hit tab, then you can see here Python 3.4 config or Python 3 config is present here. So you need to provide that particular file link here, that is Python 3 config. So Python 3 config is present here, and then you need enable GUI, these are scope sum, and this is enable fail if missing. So if some failure occurs during configuration, then it will give you error. So I'll copy this command, copy, and I'll go to this terminal, and I'm inside Vim here. So I'll type ls, and then what I'll do, I'll just paste that command by prefixing a sudo before it. So this is the command that I have copy pasted, and I'll hit enter. Now what this will do, this will try to configure my Vim software, the Vim that we have cloned, as this is a default step for installing any particular software in Linux. So Vim has been successfully configured, and now the default step, that is make step. So we'll type the command sudo make, and this will do what? This will make the Vim source code, that it will compile it and convert to this object codes and something else which is needed. So the make command is also success, and now we will install Vim by typing the command sudo make install. So what this will do, this will copy the compiled files to the particular directories from where Vim can be accessed. Now if I type command Vim, so this is the magic, that Vim version 8.1 has been installed on your system. So this will install the latest version of Vim because you have cloned the GitHub repository, and that is the latest thing that the Vim guys have released. So this is Vim 8.1. Now if I hit write and quit, then I will exit the Vim, and if I say Vim minus minus version, then you can see the version of the Vim plus all the features that are being supported by Vim is present here. So here you need to find this Python 3 thing, and this is the important thing that you need to take into mind, that this should be plus, that is your Vim is supporting Python 3. So Python 3 interpreter is supported. So these were all the steps how to install Vim. Now the next step is what? The next step is to install Vim plugin manager. So it is just a single step. I have explained the detail of this installing Vim plugin manager on my channel, and there is a video for that. You can go that, you can click the link above that is being shown you. So what I'll do, I'll go to my browser, and here I'll search for Vim plug. Only Vim plug. So I'll search for Vim plug, and this will give me the first link. So I'll come here, and what I need to do, I need to just copy this command. So I'll copy this command. If you need detailed explanation, then you can go to that particular video. We have copied the command and we need to paste it here. So we have successfully pasted this command, and this will install Vim plug. Now what we need to do, we need to follow the next step. And what the next step says, you need to install YouCompleteMe Vim plugin. So how to install YouCompleteMe Vim plugin? So first we have installed this Vim plug, and that will give you what? That will give you these configurations which are present. If you want to know the details, you can go through it, but we need to copy this command. So I'll come to my terminal, and in my home folder, I will edit my vimrc file, and I'll paste that particular command here. And the next command what we need to paste this end command. So we'll come here and we'll control C and we'll paste that particular command. So this is what, how my Vim plug will work. Now I'll try to install the Vim plugin, that is YouCompleteMe. So I'll search for YouCompleteMe. YouCompleteMe Vim. So this will give you the GitHub repository here. This is YouCompleteMe. And what you need to do, you need to copy this name. So we'll copy this name and we'll say plug, and then the name of repository, this one, Valeric YouCompleteMe. And then what we need to do, we need to open Vim like this. We need to just type the command, and then we need to press shift colon and then plug install. So we need to type this command and we need to hit enter. So what this will do, this will try to download the YouCompleteMe plugin from GitHub, and it, because there are so many submodules which we'll see in the later stage, it will try to download all those submodules. So you can see here, this particular plugin depends on hell lot of other plugins. So there are more than 15 to 20 plugins on which this particular YouCompleteMe plugin depends. So you need to, this command, that is Vim plug install, will download or will clone all those submodules into your local system. So YouCompleteMe has been successfully downloaded here. So we'll quit this by typing shift colon and quit. So we'll quit Vim, and you can see these many libraries were installed, or these many submodules were installed during the installation of YouCompleteMe. Now where it got installed? So I'll go to my home directory by typing cd command. This will take me to my home directory, and this tilde sign tells that I'm in my home directory. If I do ls minus la, you can see there is a .vim folder present. So I'll go inside .vim folder, and here you can see there is this plugged. This folder has been created because of the Vim plug that we have installed. So I'll go inside this plugged, and you can see here this ucompleteme folder is present. I'll go inside this ucompleteme folder, and these are the files which are needed by ucompleteme plugin to run itself. Now, till now we have not completed the step. So we'll follow the next step, and that is what? Install CMake. So we'll install CMake by typing sudo yum install CMake. So this is a simple step. It will do what? It will install CMake on your system, because this ucompleteme plugin needs CMake during its compilation process. So this will install CMake on our system. So once CMake has been successfully installed, then we need to go to our next step, that is install pip 3.4. So how to install pip 3.4? So we'll do a yum search of what? Yum search pip. So we'll do a yum search of pip, and you can see here there is python 3 4 pip no arc rpm are tools for installing and managing python 3 packages. So I'll copy it, and I'll do sudo yum install and then the rpm name. So this will try to download, and this will try to install this particular yum repository. From the yum repository, it will try to install that particular RPM, but I think it has already been installed on my system, so it is there. Now, I am present inside my ucompleteme folder that we have downloaded using Vim plug, and you know about that. So the next step is what? You need to create a virtual environment. So for creating a virtual environment, you need to first download it. So we'll say pip 3.4 install virtual environment. So we'll say please download it. So I think it is already downloaded on my system. So, but you need to follow this step of downloading it. Now we'll create a new virtual environment in our current directory. So we'll say virtual environment and then venv. So this will create a virtual environment folder, and you need to note that this Python 3.4 must be written here, because without this your code completion will not work. Now you can see here this venv folder is present here. So we'll activate our virtual environment by typing source venv bin and then activate. So what this will do, this will activate the virtual environment, and you can see here this venv sign has come here. So previously it was not there, and now it has come. So our virtual environment is active. So once the virtual environment is active, we'll go to our next step, that is what? We'll compile our ucompleteme with clang completer. So here you can see a file is present here, install.py, and what we'll type, install.py and then clang completer, C-U-M-P-L-E-T-R. So it says install.py clang completer, which means compile the current ucompleteme version with clang completer features. So you can see here the 3.4m.so library is needed for compilation process. So during the compilation, what it will do, it will download some file and it will build the files. So the compilation process of ucompleteme is complete, and it's a success. That is very good for you. So once it is success, then what we'll do, we'll go to our home directory here by typing the command cd, and this is our home directory. So here I'll do ls minus la. So here you can find this vimrc and vim folder is also present. So we'll go to our next step, and the next step says what? We need to do some configuration related to ucompleteme. So first we'll go to ucompleteme website here, ucompleteme GitHub repository, and you can see here there is a lot of documentation here. So you can configure your ucompleteme using these configurations. Like you can go to the bottom and you can see there are so many configuration commands here. So like this one, these are not commands. I'll go for the commands directly. Like this, let g equal to y cm disable for files larger than kb equal to 1000. So there are so many configuration related to ucompleteme. So I have taken some important configuration, and these are present here. So this can be found on my GitHub repo also. So if I go here on my GitHub repo, so there was some gist. So this is the gist. I'll again go to my gist here. I'll share the link also here in the description below. So here these are my Vim settings. So you can see here, this is the whole Vim setting that I use for my development purpose. So here what I'll do, I'll copy this one, let GCM, and then up to here I'll copy it. And then what I'll do, I'll come to my vimrc file here. Vimrc file is present in my home directory, and I'll paste those configuration here. And I only need what? This one. The Python library part should be given as Python 3. And then the auto close preview window after completion, which is an important feature, that suppose after auto completion you have selected the thing that you want, then it should auto close it. And then the number of minimum character for completion, that how many character do you type, and there is a completion, so I have written it 1. So now our configuration is complete. So our virtual environment is also active, so we'll deactivate it now, and I'll create a new project, and that project is what? Mkdir. Suppose there is a project, any app is there, so this is app. So during the development of Python related project, we create a virtual environment. So I'll again create a virtual environment, and that will be what? Virtual environment VNV. So this is the virtual environment for this particular project. So it will create a virtual environment here, and then we'll activate it, and then we'll work it in this particular directory. So it is installing the setup tools. I'll do ls, then this VNV folder is present here, and I'll source it by typing source bin activate. So this will activate my virtual environment. Now I'll type a simple Python file, that is vim test.py, and here what I'll do, I'll say import OS. So suppose I have imported OS, and then I'll do what? Now you can see I type O, and there's a completion O, and there's a import also written here. So if any keyword that you have written, that will get auto completed. And now you see the magic. The magic is here. Yes, the auto completion is working fine. And you can see here, if I hit tab, then it will rotate through all the things. So at present, my this chdir is present. Then if I hit tab, it will come to ch mode. And the beauty is here, the description about this function is present here. So being in the Vim only, you can see all the definitions and all the what this particular function does. Now this is the OS module which is built in inside Python. Now we'll download some Python modules which are third-party system. So what I'll do, I'll type Python 3.4 and then install requests. So this is an important library that most of the Python developer must have used, that is request, which is used to send HTTP request over the network. So what this will do, this will download the request Python module inside our virtual environment kind of file. So it is complete, it is success. And now again we'll do what? We'll do vim test.py, and we'll import our requests module. So we have imported it, and now this is request, this is auto completion. So you can see auto completion is there. I type re, and you can see request. I hit tab, and it is completed. And now the magic comes here. I hit a dot, and all the suggestions are here, all the auto completions are here. So I'll type the post command. So request has a post command. So I type p, then all the suggestions related to p comes here. So I'll type post and then tab, and then you can see here the post takes a URL, a data, a JSON, and kw as the definition. So these things are coming from the doc strings that are written inside that particular module, that is request module. Now you can see the magic, how auto completion is working inside our Python. So this was all about this video, how to do auto completion. I know that this is a lengthy part, but if you are addicted to Vim, if you work in Vim, and if you are missing the most important feature that other IDs are having, that is auto completion, then you need to follow these steps, because to get something good, you need to do some hard work. Thank you. And if you like my channel, please subscribe to it. Please share these videos with other Vim developers, those who are a fan of Vim as an IDE. So it will be helpful for them also. So thank you.